Hey everybody, it's Brian Loans with the NHRA on Fox, back again with another installment of What Was Your First Race Car? Presented by QA1, and today we're catching up with a guy who everyone loves, West Coast funny car racer Alex Miladinovich, a guy who loves drag racing more than anything. Dude, what was your first race car?
Well, let me tell you, started out, I wanted to boat race. Boat racing was hot back in the 90s, and I built a 427 big block Chevy. I couldn't get a muster up V-drive boat, so what I did is I jammed it into a 1967 Chevy Camaro. It was an SSRS, and I bracket raced it at Brotherhood Raceway on Terminal Island, California out here. They converted an old container terminal into a drag strip, and they were the first drag strip to be built since all the original ones were shut down, you know, through the 70s and 80s, and you know, they did street legal drag, and we got that car to go low 12s. I don't remember the times on that, but turbo 350 and not much chassis work, but that was my first car that I took down the drag strip.
Well, I think it's amazing. Terminal Island was the like the pet project of Big Willie Robinson out there in LA, and it was really him that kind of pushed that whole thing through. And at least from my understanding, was it was not the flattest drag strip ever built.
Exactly. You know, the container terminals are set up for the rain and to get all the washout, but yeah, it had the call the Brotherhood bump, and that was it. He promoted street racing, much like NHRA did. Street legal drag racing, and to get all the high school kids to run their cars, and run what you brung was their motto. And that was my first trip down the quarter mile in the orange Chevy Camaro. One cool thing about that is it was an original car that was built factory, everything except for the motor work that we did. I didn't butcher the car up. I didn't tear it up, do the ladder bars and change all the suspension. Really kept it original, and that car led me to get into nostalgia racing, which started, you know, never really ended with front engine dragsters, with the California Hot Rod reunion starting in the 90s, and that catapulted to me getting into front engine dragsters and nostalgia racing. But that car was a lot of fun.
Tell me about your first ride in a slingshot dragster, because that is a whole different universe than a Camaro.
That driving the front engine dragster is probably the most fun you could ever have. The motor's out front, you could see the front tires. And to say the term slingshot, you're literally being shot out of a cannon. The motor out front, when you smoke the tires, you don't see the car losing traction. You see your front tires going left and front tires going right. And I eventually ended up with a 1967 Woody Gilmore. It was an old Top Fuel car. I didn't have much history on it, but it did have an original Tom Hanna body. And that car we ran at the March meet and some good guys events up at Famoso. And we got that in the 750 class with good guys. And that's when I copied that car when we got it to go 200. I figured that thing belonged in a museum, and a guy bought it, turned it into a cackle car. That's what really started me building chassis. That was such a fun car. I said, hey, let's start building front engine dragsters. And it's kind of come full circle, because everybody knows we run the funny car out of my garage, build the motors at my brother's house. Well, we're building a spare chassis, and we're going to go full circle. We're going to build our spare Top Fuel funny car chassis at my mom's house, just a couple blocks away here in Orange.
Well, hey, I mean, she wants something going on in her garage, too. You guys can't hog all the action, right?
Oh, it's awesome. You know, my mom's retired, and she loves having the team over. And she said, yo, make the guys lunch and let me know. My aunt and uncle want to come over and visit. It's a family effort. And it was kind of cool because Southern California was a hotbed in the 90s of drag racing until all the big teams moved to Indy. I mean, just a couple, you know, 10 minutes away, the Worsham's shop is here. Force is in Yorba Linda, which is, you know, two cities over. And even back in the day, you had Kenny Bernstein. Tom Hoover used to keep his stuff out here in the city of Orange. AFT clutches. And you could build a drag car within about a 1-hour drive. before we had Brad Anderson and Alan Johnson, Keith Blacks was just right up the street, right up the 710. And I worked through high school and college at an XRP dealer selling the A&N fittings. And I got to meet Dale Armstrong. The list goes on. And even Guido Dean Antonelli, when he was a crew member on one of Force's cars, he came in and bought stuff. It was awesome. And, you know, I'm a huge race fan. And to meet those guys as a kid in college and, you know, hey, I got my Camaro and my front engine dragster. Someday when I grow up, I want to drive Top Fuel funny cars. And back at that time, there wasn't much opportunity because they were five-man teams. And back then, the drivers used to work on the cars. You didn't have the mega teams. And that's what started us building the cars ourselves. Like, no one's going to let me drive their car, so we're going to do it ourselves.
I got one last question. Are you happy you didn't ever find a boat to put that motor in?
Yeah. Yeah, 100%. But I would love to have raced at Long Beach Marine Stadium. It is the coolest thing. You know, I was in high school and they got girls in V-drive bikini, you know, V-drive boats and girls in bikinis and everything. It was a cool time to be boat racing back in the 90s.
Sounds great, man. Alex, thanks for taking the time to talk to us. It's a great story, and it's always fun to see how everybody got started. We got guys like Paul Lee starting in their mom's slant six Dodge. We got you starting in a Camaro with a motor in it that you were trying to put in a boat. Everybody's got their own beginning, and this is a great way to hear yours. Thanks, man.
Thank you very much for having me.
And remember, QA1 presenting these videos, and whether you're looking for improved ride performance, show-stopping handling, or quicker times down the drag strip, QA1 can deliver. Just follow their company's motto, go drive it.